Hello and welcome to the 2019 Bachfest 5K. I'll be your host, Andrew Kennedy. Come along with me as we watch our leaders lead their way through beautiful Over the Rhine, then through downtown Cincinnati and back to OTR for the finish and celebration. The Bachfest 5K course starts in the heart of Over the Rhine Brewing District of Cincinnati, and that is where we are right now. Now let's talk about the course today, and let's take a look at this high-tech graphic of the course. How about that? Here we go. That is the course, starting over the Rhine in the top left-hand corner, weaving down, going east, and then a little north, and then they'll glide down right along 71 and 471 there, right past the casino, loop around downtown, and make their way back up. There are some hills in this, and that'll be interesting as I try to climb up and follow these guys. Let's take a little 360 view. I'll be riding along with Patrick there, the lead men's, and I'll try to swoop around and grab the women's race too. Maybe try to grab the women's race at the beginning here and catch up to our men. By the end, we'll circle back and grab both our men's and women's leader. And you can hear excitement building and tension mounting here as we get ready for, I believe this is the 27th annual Bachfest 5K. Or at least this is the 27th annual Bachfest. I don't know how long the 5K has been going on. Bachfest is a uniquely Cincinnati event. And celebrating the brewing of Bach beer coming in the coming of spring. Bach beer is traditionally brewed for special occasions. It's complex and hearty. Traditional. And traditionally has a higher nutritional content than most beer, and typically has a higher alcohol content too, which most of you guys like. Let's pause for the national anthem. Starting line, it says TQL there. Did you know the TQL beer series benefits the Over the Rhine Brewery District Community Urban Development Corporation? It's a nonprofit organization committing to making the brewery district a healthy, balanced, and supportive neighborhood. And we're about to get ready to go here. Here we go.
And if you have not met the sausage team yet, Lewis, this is the end of an era for you today.
Yes, very sad moment for me, but it's been a great year for you.
sausage being shared?
I sleep with a sausage every night, and that's pretty much how I've done it.
Well, hopefully this year's Sausage Queen will be able to, take it.
Sleep with the sausage as well, yes.
Yes, exactly. Again, that's all going to go down tonight with the Billy Dirt Ball inside Bachfest Hall. All right. Are we ready, runners? We have 30 seconds here to the start. Let me bring Iris back. Ready for this?
We are good to go. Let's do the count.
Around here. We make our way up this hill. And I up shit a little bit. Here with the lead pack. Already a little bit of separation here. Lead pack of about a dozen runners or so, and we're gonna stick with them for a while. And see who drops off one by one as our leaders inevitably will fan out the rest of them. This guy. I always like seeing a little gray hair in the lead pack. Gives me hope. Gives me a thumbs up. Greg Lemon, our early leader, dropping back just a little bit. I think he's biting this time.
That was just for the video.
Oh, okay. Just for the video, he says. All right. Back up here with our lead runners. Easy to do so on a downhill. Got glasses in the lead here. Sweet looking mohawk.
It's a Kentucky waterfall.
Kentucky waterfall, he says. All right. Wearing the Bears jersey. In the lead, we got orange and white hat in second. Battle going on for third here between red shorts and blue shirt. Fleet feet runner here in top five. And navy blue hat in sixth. And we've thinned this down to six runners already. One of these six runners will win this race. I already have a feeling which one remains to be seen. Do we have some runners that are hanging back and being conservative? Or are they fading? Only time will tell. Coming up on the 1 mile mark. One mile. And I would give you a time, but it's not about time. It's about who wins. What is it?
5:25.
5:25 for that first mile, says the runner in the lead. Mr. Kentucky Waterfall. Here we go. It's getting exciting now. We got the casino just up ahead. This is what the runners are seeing. Another added level of excitement is you never know if I'm going to fall. Got some people cheering on the course. This is what the runners will be seeing as they come through the B Run Project. All right. Thank you, officer. Always thank the Cincinnati police for coming out and keeping these runners safe, the bicyclists safe, everyone safe. So we got blue shirt. Took the lead on the downhill. I could tell that he's a downhill runner and he used that downhill to his advantage, those long legs. Kentucky Waterfall said, "All right, I'll let you take it. I'm gonna sit right behind you. Let you take some of the wind away from me." So let's see if Blue Shirt can make a move out of this. Did he take the lead to make a big statement? Did he take the lead to pump himself up? We'll see what he's going to do with this lead. Kentucky Waterfall says, "Hey, I'll let you take it." Now we are down to our top five. Let's see where Greg Lemon is. He's back in eighth place right now, our early leader. See you, Greg. All right. But here we have our top five, narrowing the field down as we make our way into downtown Cincinnati, close to Sawyer Point. And I'll tell you what, most, with the exception of that uphill in the very beginning, it's been mostly downhill as we make our way closer to the river. And then it will be a mostly slight uphill towards the finish, which is really going to be a lot for these runners. I always hated ending on an uphill, and that is exactly what these warriors are going to be doing here. We're taking a look at our top three. We got some cheering going on there. Look at that. There they go. That's what makes Cincinnati a great running community. A lot of people come out and just cheer you on. It's fun. All right, we're going to take a right here. It says Patrick, our lead bicyclist up there. And we make the turn. Let's get one last one. Back this way. We've got a fifth place runner right here. And here we go, another right turn as we make our way under this overpass. Let's get back up here with our leaders. He says 37. He's talking and running at the same time. You know that's a good sign. You know he's feeling well. Second, third place say, all right, I'll let you talk. I'll let you wear yourself out to the bicyclist. Here we go. I'm gonna have to do some work and catch up to these guys. Because even though I'm on a bike, they're running fast. Great job. Look at the runners over there. Passing the warriors back in the chase packs. No commentation from me right now. I'm concentrating on getting up this hill. Whew. Down to runners one and two. Runners three, four, five, and six have dropped off. And here we go. About a half mile to go now. As lactic acid is building up in their legs. Who will be the true champion of the day? The Bachfest 5K 2019 champion. This is exciting stuff. I always hate it when there's one runner that just takes it. And now we got a battle. You're watching two warriors go at it head to head, and they mean business. And here they go. A couple more turns here as we make our way to the finish. Look at this. It's gonna be a battle. It's gonna be a one run to the finish of it. Oh, red shorts taking the lead. A bold statement. Is he gonna run himself out? Is he taking this one? Kentucky Waterfall says, nah, I got you. I'll let you take this. I don't think you got it in you. Looking strong, both of these runners. Look at the power. Look at the power in the legs. Red shorts turns the corner. Does he recognize how far he's got to go? Does he say, oh snap, did I go too early? Or is he saying, I've got this? Kentucky Waterfall says, oh, I think he went too early and I'm closing the gap. Here we go. From about 10 yards to 5 yards, Kentucky Waterfall right on his heels. Red Short says, I still got this. Traffic stopped to watch this epic battle take place. Didn't get any better than this. Side by side. Side by side, the lead bicyclist saying, get out of the way, runners. Get out of the way, car. We got a race going on. And look at this, Kentucky Waterfall says, I got this. And here we come back up to where we started. Not much longer to go. Here we go. Who wants it? It all comes down to this. Point one left. The lead has been exchanged I don't know how many times. And here these runners go. I can see the finish. I can see it. Here they go now. Who wants it? They're both giving it everything they got. Woo, man. And here we go. It looks to be Kentucky Waterfall taking it all the way in. Look at this. Look at the power. Back and find our. Oh, and there's some lactic acid building up in his legs, you can tell. Let's find our lead female. What a battle! It's not every day it comes down to the wire like that. That was fun to watch. And there's Patrick.
Nice run, guys! Nice run!
Course official. Doing a great job.
Nice run.
You can see Patrick did his job getting that truck out of the way at the very end, and that was dangerous.
Nice run, guys.
And here's our lead female.
This morning. immediately following the race. We've got water, we've got bananas, we've got cheese cones, and again, most importantly, we've got beer. All right, big round of applause as the runners, as they cross the finish line here for the 7th annual Bachfest 5K.
Number three.
Special thanks to all of our Brew Hosh and to Total Quality Logistics, the title sponsor of the TQL Beer Series. Still time to sign up and get Brew Hog for 2019. That makes me sweat.
Hey, winner! Winner! Greg! 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 Gregory Lemon! Greg! I gotta get my interview with the winner here.
We're just talking about how annoying you are.
I know, right?
All right, well, let's get an interview.
All right, so what's your first and last name? Where are you from?
My name is Will Daring. I'm from Fort Thomas, Kentucky. What else?
Who do you run for?
I don't run for anybody. I'm an assistant track coach at Northern Kentucky.
He runs for himself. My nickname for you the whole time was Kentucky Waterfall. That's what the name of the haircut is. Is that what you said?
Oh, yeah.
Well, tell me how the race went down.
I tried to keep it pretty consistent. I went out a little slower. We went out like 4:24, I think. And I was hoping to go out 5:15, but it was tough because I was just playing in my mind that the rest of the race is uphill, so I might as well save it. So, and it turned out to be a pretty good strategy because we went 5:10 down the hill and then just had to push all the way back up. So,
wow, that was incredible. And you guys switched leads. I don't know how many times. He took it. Did you know that he took it too soon, or were you just hoping that, or were you?
I was hoping it, but also I was kind of like, I think he misunderstands it's all uphill until you get to the very top. So I just waited until we hit that top, and I was like, as soon as I hit the top, I'm just gonna cruise it in.
The poise, the confidence, the patience that you had, that was incredible. That was really good. I love it. Well, I really appreciate you spending the time to talk to me. What do you think about this race in general? What do you think about the Bachfest?
I like the Bachfest. I ran last year and I got second and there was nobody to run with, so the guy that beat me went miles ahead of me, and so it was fun this year being in a group of like 5-6 guys just trying to figure out everybody's race strategy and going at it. So
well, that's amazing. Second place last year, first place this year.
Yep.
Kentucky Waterfall. It's more fun to say that instead. I'll always know you as Kentucky Waterfall.
Thanks.
Well, that was fantastic. Best of luck to you.
Thank
and
you.
Here's Gregory Lemon.
Hey,
beer connoisseur extraordinaire. What'd you think of the race, Greg?
Yeah, I had fun. I wanted to make sure I was on camera, so I took the lead when no one else was.
Yes.
And that was fun. And then ran about what I thought, just over 17 minutes. And you never know who you're going to be around. The guy with gray hair beat me. Well played by him.
Top 10 though, right?
Yeah, top 10 was what I thought I'd be. And so I was right in the mix. And just sort of, it's a good race. Gonna gear up for Flying Pig half probably. Gonna start training for it. I got some work to do.
This dude will smoke me in the half. No doubt about it. He's got me there.
Cool, I'm gonna cool down and then we'll have a beer here in about 10 minutes.
Yeah, absolutely. We'll let you guys cool down.
Thank you.
Absolutely. There's your lead runner and top 10 runner right there. Love it. And let's go back and see if we can grab our lead female runner and close out this while I go get a beer. Let's see here.
Congratulations to all of our runners as they sprint across the finish line. Again, the first race of the TQL Beer Series for 2019. So plenty of time to get yourself signed up to be a brew hop this year. For the from the Black Tie Scout Day benefit. Over the line brewing district, preserving, restoring, and redeveloping our unique brewing history and historic urban fabric. I mean, just following the race, there is bananas for my white gold. We've got water from Pepsi, and we'll have all of our winners here announced in just a moment.
Can I get a word with you?
Sure.
All right, come over here away from the speaker.
All right. We are here now to congratulate first, second, and third in the
men's. All right, thanks for taking the time to talk to me. What's your first name and last, and who do you run for?
Elizabeth Heinbach, and I run with Sneaky.
Nice. And tell me about the race today.
Really happy with it. I wasn't sure what to expect. I've been training for a half Ironman later this summer, so I've been changing up my training, so I wasn't sure what to expect coming into this. I'm really happy with it.
Nice. Now, was anyone with you the whole way, or were you all alone by yourself?
I had some guys with me, like some of the Fleet Feet guys around me, so that was nice.
Nice.
Yeah.
And who'd you say you run for?
Fleet Feet.
You don't run for college or anything?
No.
You're just out running for yourself. I love it. And say your first name again?
Elizabeth,
and tell me, what do you think about the Bach Fest in general?
This is my first event with it. It's super fun. Excited to get some beer in Skyline.
Yeah, look at that. You got a six pack there. That's what you get for winning, huh?
Yep.
Awesome. Elizabeth, great job. You look fantastic. You look so poised and so within yourself. It was great watching you. It looked like you need someone to push you. So next year, all you female runners, get out there and push Elizabeth. She needs some more competition.
Thank you.
Great run. I'll see you later.
Thanks.
There you have it, the Bach Fest 5K. We round this out. Can I go get a beer?
Don't forget bananas, water, medals.
We're gonna final shot here at the finish.
Cheese cones and beer are in your future. Sam Evans, Sarah Jones, Alex Clark, Jonathan Michaels, big round of applause again to everybody participating this morning in the 7th annual Bach Fest 5K, brought to you by TQL. Sammy Getz, Chris Schroeder. Bach Fest